Hello students, welcome to this online lecture of computer science. In previous lectures, we have seen the chapter number 1 and chapter number 2 that was totally depend on the microprocessor 8085. So in previous chapter, we have already studied the instruction sets like addressing modes in 8085, instruction set, assembly language programs, block diagram of microprocessor, etc. So today's lecture we are going to start with the chapter number 3, that is introduction to Intel 86 family. So this microprocessor developed by Intel and known as a 86 family, this chapter describes their features and brief information of the 8086 is same as 8085, but the only difference is that there are few more advantages in 8086 microprocessor. So as we have seen in the last topic, that the first microprocessor was a 4-bit microprocessor. And then in 1978, Intel introduced the microprocessor 8088 and 8086. Intel started this family by means of advanced versions such as 80286, 80386, 80486, working as a powerful microprocessor. So 8086, this microprocessor, it is a 16-bit microprocessor. And oriented towards the high-level languages. They have powerful instruction sets and are capable of addressing megabytes of memory. For example, Intel 8086, 8088, 80186, 80286. So these all are the 16-bit microprocessor. Apart from design and concept and instruction sets, one of the critical factors that decide capability of microprocessor is the number of pins available. 8085, as we have seen that 8085 had 40-pin DIP package, that is dual inline package. Now we will see how many pins are there in 8086. Before that, we will see the objectives of this 8086 family. So it's objectives are increase execution speed. So whenever the program we run, the speed of it should be fast. So the execution should be fast as compared to other microprocessor. Increase memory addressing capacity. Provide a powerful instruction set, function in multi-processor environment. As we have seen that it has oriented towards high-level languages. Now let's start with the features of each microprocessor. First of all, we will start with the features of 8086. We have already seen in the first chapter the features of 8085. Now in this third chapter, we are going to see the features of 8086 and 8088. The first feature is, it is a 16-bit microprocessor. सेकेंड इट इज़ इट हैज़ 40 पिन डीआईपी पैकेज. व्हाट डज डीआईपी मीन? डीआईपी मीन ड्यूअल इन लाइन पैकेज, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंपोनेंट पैकेज विथ अ रेक्टेंगुलर हाउसिंग एंड टू पैरेलल रोज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल कनेक्टिंग पिन. दिस इज नोन एज अ ड्यूअल इन लाइन पैकेज. द नेक्स्ट इट इज कैपेबल ऑफ एड्रेसिंग 1 MB ऑफ मेमोरी. इट्स एड्रेस बस इज 20 बिट. वॉट डज एड्रेस बस मीन? आर्किटेक्चर यूज टू ट्रांसफर डेटा बिटवीन डिवाइसेस. दिस इज नोन एज अ address bus. We have already seen this address bus clock frequency definition in the first chapter. So its address bus is 20 bit. Clock frequency it is 5 megahertz to 10 megahertz. Clock frequency means it measures the number of cycles your CPU executes per second. The next, it is 8-bit external data bus. What does data bus mean? Data bus, it is a system within a computer or device consisting of a connector or set of a wire. It might be directional or unidirectional or bidirectional. So data bus can be in one direction, that is unidirectional, or in the both direction, that is in the bidirectional. So it is a 8-bit external data bus. Signals for multiprocessor environment. 8088 and 8086 are identical in internal architecture, only differ in external design. So the data bus and status signals are multiplexed with the address bus. As we know that address bus, it is the architecture used to transfer data between the devices, between two devices or the more devices. So it is a 16 data lines which starts from AD0 to AD15 multiplex. What does multiplex mean? Multiplex means one input and many output, and demultiplex means many input and one output. So we have seen the features of the Intel 8086 and 8088. Now we are going to see the Intel architecture of 8086. So you can see this diagram. Basically, this block diagram, it is divided into two parts. The first part, it is the EU, that is the execution unit. And the second part, it is the BIU, that is bus interface unit. When 8085 microprocessor fetches and executes the instruction, the buses are occupied for the fetch operation but remains idle during internal execution of an instruction. To speed up the execution, 8086 processor includes two processing units called as this, the first, that is the execution unit, and the bus interface unit, that is BIU. The concept of dividing work between the two units and processing it simultaneously speeds up the execution. Basically, why these blocks are divided, as the main reason is that it can speed up the execution. So BIU fetches the instruction, it receives the instruction and places them in instruction queue. An execution unit continuously execute them until it becomes empty. Such a processing is known as a parallel processing. So basically this BIU, it fetches instructions and it gives to the execution unit, and this execution unit continuously executes them until it becomes empty. So this first block in the BIU, it is a segment resistor. Segment resistor, it provides a base resistor, and another resistor supplies offset address to increase memory addressing capacity. So basically, what is this segment resistor? This segment resistor, it is used to increase the memory addressing capacity. So the CS, DS, SS, ES, IP, this all are the segment resistor. And in execution unit, this data register, point registers, and index register, this all three are the general registers. So the general register, this AX, BX, CX, up to DI. So all these are the general registers. We will see the meaning of each and every register of these general registers and segment registers afterwards. Now let's see these registers. General registers, that is AX, BX, CX, DX. You can see here AX, BX, CX, DX. These four are the data registers. So why these four registers are used, data registers? So these 8086 processor includes 4-bit general purpose registers. The next, it is the SP, BP, SI, and DI. You can see here SP, BP, SI, and DI, pointer registers and index registers. So these are used for 16-bit registers as a memory pointers. SP means stack pointer, BP means base pointer, SI means source index, and DI is destination index, which are used as a index registers, which are not present in 8085. So these registers are not present in 8085. Next group of resistors are called as a segment resistors. So code segment, data segment, stack register, extra segment. Now we will see the flag registers of 8086. What does flag mean? We have seen in the first chapter, flag, it is nothing but the flip-flop. Flip-flop is the on-off condition or 0-1 condition. So basically, the first 5 bits are identical to 8085. In data flag category, you can see here OF, that is overflow flag, is there. Its resets of the flags are same as 8085 flags. So OF flag, over flag, overflow flag, it is used as a signed numbers when the result of the signed numbers is too large, causing MSB, that is most significant bit, to overflow into sign bit. This flag is set. The next, it is the DF. DF, it is the directional flag. So directional flag, it is used to control the direction, that is to increment or decrement the string operations. The next, it is the IF. IF, it is nothing but the interrupt flag. So interrupt flag, it is used to enable or disable external mask able interrupt request. and the last it is the TF, that is the trap flag. It is used for single stepping instructions. Now we will see the comparison between the 8085 and 8086. So the first point it is that the data bus size. So 8085 microprocessor, it is a 8-bit microprocessor, and 8086 it is a 16-bit data bus. It is a 16-bit microprocessor. The second point, it is the address bus size. So 8085, it is a 16-bit address. It has a 16-bit address, hence can access 64 KB memory. And the 8086 microprocessor, it is a 20-bit address bus, hence can access 1 MB memory. So it has more memory. The third point, it is the clock speed. So the clock speed, it is nothing but the measure the number of cycles your CPU executes per second. Clock speed. So the clock speed of the microprocessor 8085 is 3 MHz, and the clock speed of the 8086 microprocessor, it varies in the range of 5.8 to 10 MHz. The next, it is the duty cycle for clock, that is 50% and 33% flags. It has 5 flags: sign, zero, auxiliary, carry, parity, and again carry. And 8086 has 9 flags, that is overflow, OF, DF, IF and TF. That is overflow flag, interrupt, trap, sign, zero, auxiliary, carry, parity, carry. And the operation mode, it is operated in 1, and the 8086, it is operated in 2 modes. So in today's lecture, we have seen the comparison of 8085 and 8086 and the architecture of the 8086, its features, Intel features of 8086, 8088, and the primary objectives of the 86 family. So in next lecture, we are going to see the features of 80286, features of 80386.